गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो इन लास्ट क्लास प्रीवियस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। नो यस इन दैट फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड डी क्यू इज इक्वल टू डी यू प्लस डी डब्ल्यू। अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एनर्जी विच इज सप्लाई टू अ गैस विल बी यूटिलाइज इन इंक्रीजिंग द इंटरनल एनर्जी ऑफ ए गैस एंड work done on a gas. This is first law of thermodynamics, and while applying first law of thermodynamics to any system we need to follow sign conventions. What are the sign conventions? Whether to take dq, du and dw, whether they have to take it as positive or negative. Okay, now for example there is one system. If we add heat energy to that system, the dq we should take it as positive. If you subtract dh energy, subtract heat energy from the system, then dq we should take it as negative. Clear? And if internal energy of any system or any gas increases, then we should take du as positive, and internal energy if it decreases we have to take it as negative. Okay, then what about the work done? If work is done by the system or by any gas, then dw we should take it as positive. If work is done on the system or on the gas, then dw we should take it as negative. Clear? And about this we have discussed in last class, and one or two examples also I have given. Okay, we need to solve with sign conventions by using this first law of thermodynamics. Na, according to first law of thermodynamics, the amount of heat energy which is supplied to a system is utilized to increase the internal energy of any system and work done by the system. Clear? Okay, yes. Now let us discuss about the Cp and Cv. These are very important. What is Cp and what is Cv? These, Nana? Cp means what? Specific heat capacity at constant pressure. What is that, Nana? Specific heat capacity at constant pressure. Cv is specific heat capacity at constant volume. Nana, at constant what? Volume. Clear? And the two I am talking about the molar specific heat capacity. What I am talking about? Molar specific heat capacities. Okay, yeah. See, as we know, the heat energy which is supplied to the gas or any system or any object, formula is ms delta t. You know this. For any substance, what is the heat energy you are supplying with for increase in temperature of the substance? Formula what, Nana? Q is equal to ms delta t. What is n here? Mass of a substance. What is s here? Specific heat of a substance. What is delta T? Temperature, increase in temperature. Okay, now if I am talking about gases, then for gases I told you we have to write it like this. Clear? Yes. Here n indicates moles, number of moles of a gas, composition of gas, number of moles. C indicates molar specific heat capacity. Simply you can call it as specific heat capacity. Delta T is rising temperature of the gas. So we are talking about gases. So I will take this equation. What is m c delta t? Clear? Okay. Yes. Now let us suppose we have given. For example, we are having something like this. This is n. Sorry. N moles of a gas or one mole of a gas we are having. Let us suppose we are having one mole of a gas. Means n will equal to what, Nana? One. Clear? And let us suppose we are adding some heat energy to this gas. We are supplying some heat energy to this gas. Okay? Clear? What will happen, Nana? Gas. This total is gas. This is a container filled with gas. What will happen? This gas may expand. When it is expanding, there may be some changes in temperature, pressure and volume. Clear? Are you getting? Now let us suppose a small amount of heat energy that we are supplying for 1 mole of a gas, then it will become C dT. N is equal to 1 mole. For 1 mole of a gas, let us suppose we are supplying a heat energy which is dQ. Due to this heat energy dQ, what will happen in us? Temperature of that 1 mole of a gas will increase. Clear? Are you getting? Now, this supplying heat energy to the gas, we can perform in two methods. One is at constant volume. If you keep volume constant, at that constant volume, if you supply heat energy to that, then specific heat capacity will be taken as at constant volume. CV indicates specific heat capacity at the constant volume into rising temperature. Are you understanding what I am saying? Let us suppose we are having 1 mole of a gas. For that 1 mole of a gas, let us suppose we are supplying some heat energy to that gas. Then what will happen? Temperature of that gas may increase. How much it can increase for 1 mole of a gas? It will be CV dT. Why I am taking CV instead of C? Instead of taking C, why I am taking CV? Because I have specified one condition. That is, we are supplying this heat energy at constant volume. Let us suppose. Okay? Clear? Now, let us suppose, again, if you supply heat energy at a constant pressure, if you supply heat energy, how much heat energy you can supply for 1 mole of a gas is nothing but Cp into dT. Temperature of a gas again will increase. But here, at this time, what will happen? Specific capacity will be constant at pressure. Means at a constant pressure, we have to take specific capacity. So dQ value will be Cp dT. Okay, right? Are you understanding what is Cp and Cv means? Okay, now Cp indicates specific capacity at constant pressure. Cv indicates specific capacity at constant volume. Okay, now let us suppose for this gas, for 1 mole of a gas, let us suppose we are increasing the temperature by 1 degree centigrade. Let us suppose. Then what will happen to dQ, Rana? dQ will be equal to CV. Let us suppose we are having 1 mole of a gas. For that 1 mole of a gas, let us suppose we need to increase the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by 1 degree centigrade. How much heat energy that we need to supply? That depends upon the condition, whether you are supplying heat energy at constant volume or at constant pressure. If you are supplying heat energy at constant volume for 1 degree rising temperature for 1 mole of a gas, then heat energy that you need to give will be equal to Cv. Did you understand? Means Cv is nothing but amount of heat energy required to rise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas. What is 1 mole of a gas by 1 degree centigrade. Amount of heat energy required to rise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by 1 degree centigrade at constant volume. That is called as Cv. In a similar manner, dT is equal to 1 degree state here also. Then dQ will become Cp. Cp is nothing but amount of heat energy required to rise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by 1 degree centigrade at constant pressure. Clear? So definition wise, very clear. Now let us apply first law of thermodynamics to this. According to first law of thermodynamics, we know dQ is equal to dU plus dW. Clear? We know dW is what? Work done by the gas. Whenever you give some heat energy to the gas, some work will be performed by the gas or some work will be performed on the gas. What is the formula for work done, Nana? Work done formula is CdV. We have derived this one. Means heat energy that we need to supply according to first law of thermodynamics is dQ is equal to dU plus CdV. Clear? Are you understanding, Anna? Now, let us suppose we are supplying heat energy to the gas. We are supplying heat energy to the gas at constant volume. Volume if you keep constant, then dV is what, Nana? dV value what, Nana? If volume is constant, what will be dV value, Nana? Change in volume will be zero. Clear? If change in volume is zero, then what is the work done on this gas or system? Zero. Work done on the gas or system is what, Nana? Zero. That means whatever the heat energy that you are supplying to the gas is utilized only in increase in the internal energy of the gas. No work will be performed by the gas or on the gas. Why? Because we have kept volume constant. Clear? Are you understanding? Now, let us come back to the same point. When we keep volume constant, let us suppose we are having 1 mole of a gas. 1 mole of a gas we are having. Clear? For this 1 mole of a gas, if you want to increase the temperature by 1 degree centigrade, how much heat energy that we need to supply? Is nothing but CV. Clear? This CV is what, Anand? DU. Means, if we keep the volume constant, whatever the heat energy that we are supplying, that totally utilized to increase the internal energy of a gas. No work will be performed on the system. This much CV it will be. Clear? Or you can say dQ is equal to this much. When you keep volume constant, means when a specific capacity volume is, when we are having CV value, the heat energy that we are supplying, that will be utilized in increasing the internal energy of the gas alone. No work will be performed. Whereas if we keep pressure constant, if we keep pressure constant, according to first law of thermodynamics, dQ is equal to dU plus PdV, nothing but work done. Are you understanding? Again, write first law of thermodynamics formula, dQ is equal to dU plus dW. Now here pressure is constant. If you keep pressure constant, nothing will happen to volume. dV will be there. Volume will expand. Means whatever the heat energy that we are supplying at constant pressure, that will be utilized in increasing the internal energy of a gas and in performing some work done. Difference, are you understanding what I am saying? Gas you take, 1 mole of a gas. What do you have to take? You take 1 mole of a gas. This one container. In this, 1 mole of gas is there. Okay? For this gas, you need to increase its temperature by 1 degree centigrade. For this, what do you need to do? You need to supply some heat energy to this. Okay? If you supply heat energy at constant volume, if you keep volume constant, what will happen? No work will be done. Means that gas is not expanding, not compressing. Whatever the heat energy that you are giving, that totally will be utilized in increasing the temperature. Means in increasing the internal energy. Internal energy, how much you are increasing? 1 degree centigrade. Temperature you are increasing. Are you understanding? Clear? Means for 1 degree rise in temperature, how much energy you need? That much energy you need to supply to the gas at constant volume. Whereas if you take at constant pressure, if you keep pressure constant, what about volume? It may expand. Whenever expansion is there or compression is there, whenever changes in the volume are present, then work will be performed by that heat energy. Means in this case, now whatever the heat energy that we are supplying, whatever the heat energy that we are supplying to the gas is utilized in increasing the internal energy, and at the same time it has to perform some work also. Clear? That means in both these cases, in which case you need to supply more heat energy, You need to supply more heat energy at constant volume, because in both the cases you need to raise the temperature by 1 degree centigrade. Our aim is to raise the temperature by 1 degree centigrade. But in this case, only temperature is increasing. Less amount of heat energy is required. Whereas in this case, some extra work also is done. So that's why heat energy that we need to supply to the gas is more. Are you getting clear? Okay, that means specific capacity at constant pressure is greater than specific capacity at constant volume. Did you understand what I'm saying? At constant pressure, what is specific heat capacity? Specific heat capacity is nothing but amount of heat energy required per mole per rise in temperature. If you take at constant pressure for 1 mole of a gas for 1 degree rise in temperature, how much heat energy you need required? That is called as specific heat capacity at constant pressure. For 1 mole of a gas for 1 degree rise in temperature, how much heat energy that we need to require at constant volume? That is called as CV. Clear?
Yes.
So always CP value is greater than CV value. CP value is always, it is greater than CV value. Okay? Yeah. Means this I take CV. Just now I told you N is equal to 1 and DT is equal to 1. Then CV is equal to DQ. That will be utilized in increasing the temperature. This is DQ and this DQ is nothing but CV. Just now I told you. And here it is nothing but CP. CP is more than CV. Now, if we take the difference between these two, if we take the difference between these two, what the difference here I'll take? CP minus CV is equal to, what is CP? DU plus DW. This is CP. Heat energy required to increase the internal energy and performing work done. Minus, what is CV? Heat energy required to increase the internal energy of the gas alone. DU. DU, DU cancel. You will get CP minus CV is equal to DW. Okay, yes, good, good. Good initial. Now, we know from ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. PV is equal to what, Nana? nRT. Now, take N is equal to 1 mole. 1 mole of a gas. Then PV is equal to RT, we can write. Clear?
Yes.
Now, let us differentiate this equation with respect to time. Let us keep a pressure constant. Okay? Clear? Now we'll get a PdV is equal to RdT, we can write. Did you understand? PdV by dt is equal to RdT by dt. If you differentiate with respect to time, dt dt cancel. You will get PdV is nothing but RdT. We know PdV is nothing but work done. You know this. Is nothing but RdT. Can we write? Clear?
Yes.
Now, see here in this case, increase in temperature, how much we have taken, Anna? 1 degree. DT value, how much I have taken, Anna? 1 degree centigrade. That means DW can be written as R. Can we write? I told you, increase in temperature is 1 degree. Then DW, we can write it as R. So, keep here, CP minus CV is equal to, DW is what, Anna? R. This is the relation. Here, R is universal gas constant, Anna. What is R value? Gas constant. Clear? Relation is important. How to derive this relation? This relation is important. It will be there in your material. Really. See, number of students are less. 43 only are there. We will take attendance students. Be careful.
inform to all the students. Definitely, we will take attendance every day. Only 44 students are there. Okay, is it clear? What is the relation between CP and CV? Last three steps. Not understood. I have taken PV is equal to NRT. N is equal to 1 mole of a gas we take. Then PV is equal to RT. For this equation, differentiate with respect to time. Imagine P is constant, pressure is constant. Then P will come out, dV by dt you will get. And R however constant, gas constant it is, constant value. D temperature by dt. dd dt cancel again. You will get P dV is equal to R dt. Clear? Okay. Now I told you that for 1 degree rise in temperature means delta T value how much? 1 degree. Keep one value here. R into 1 is R. Means dW is R. Substitute here. You will get Cp minus Cv is equal to R. Okay. Important relation. You need to remember this. Cp minus Cv is equal to R. Always specific capacity at constant pressure is more than at constant volume. Why? What is the reason? When you apply heat energy to the gas at constant volume, no work will be performed. Whatever the heat energy that you are supplying, that will be utilized in increasing the temperature of the gas alone. So less heat energy is required to raise the 1 degree temperature. Whereas if you supply heat energy at constant pressure, some internal energy of a gas will increase. At the same time, work will be performed on the system. Due to this reason, we need to supply more heat energy. So, heat energy which is supplied at constant pressure is more than heat energy that is supplied at constant volume. Cp is greater than Cv. Clear? Okay? Yes. So, this is the relation between Cp and Cv, Nana. Clear?
Yes.
Now, let us discuss about very important topic, and for your board exam 5 marks important, Nana, and for competitive exams also these concepts are important. Remember this. Work done in isothermal process. What is isothermal? Isothermal process means what, Anna? You know this. Isothermal process is nothing but temperature constant. If you take one gas, imagine we are having in one container gas is there, whose pressure is P, volume is V, and temperature is T. Okay? Now, do something to this gas. Means some volume of this gas somewhat you expand or you compress. Then what happens? Pressure also will change alternately. But in this case, let us imagine this container is having some walls like this. These walls are conducting walls. What are these, Nana? Conducting walls. Conducting walls means they will exchange heat energy from this system to the surrounding. Okay? Clear? Now, let us suppose if you change the volume, if you increase the volume. Diathermal walls. Yes, correct. Conducting walls are nothing but diathermal walls. Slowly, slowly heat energy will exchange between the system and surrounding. Okay. Let us suppose the gas is contained in the cylinder with a conducting wall. This gas is having some pressure, volume and temperature. Now, let us suppose some volume of the gas is changed. Then what will happen? Some pressure of the gas also will change and temperature also changes. If you keep temperature constant, at constant temperature, if you change the pressure and volume, then that process is called as isothermal process. Okay? And we know according to Boyle's law, PV is equal to always constant. This is Boyle's law. Means whenever you keep temperature constant, If pressure increases, volume decreases. They are inversely proportional. P and volume are inversely proportional, na. Okay? Isothermal process. So in isothermal process, pressure and volume are inversely proportional, but temperature remains constant. Clear? Now, in indicator diagram, if we will show on x-axis let us take volume, on y-axis let us take pressure. Okay? Now, keeping temperature constant, let us suppose there is one system is there whose pressure and volume are this P1, V1. Let us suppose these are pressure and volume. Initial state A, it is here. Now, let us suppose this gas in the initial state of P1, V1, let us suppose this gas is expanding, means volume is increasing. We know PV is equal to constant when temperature is constant. Clear? Okay, when volume increases, what will happen to pressure, Nana? Pressure decreases. Okay, so it will go like this. This is called as expansion, isothermal expansion. Means this state corresponding to B, that is some pressure P2 and some volume V2. See, volume has increased, whereas pressure has decreased. Clear? This is isothermal process we call. Here, what is constant, Anna? Temperature is constant. Temperature is constant. Remember this. And I told you, I have discussed one important point with you. That is internal energy. Internal energy. What is internal energy, Anna? Internal energy is nothing but you. This depends upon what? Kinetic energy of the gases. And kinetic energy of the gases depends upon temperature. Internal energy depends upon how randomly the gas molecules are moving. Clear? Okay. Now, if the temperature of gas constant, what about internal energy? Internal energy remains constant. Clear? That means in isothermal process, internal energy is constant. This you need to remember. Did you understand this point, what I am saying? Isothermal process, what will be there? Temperature remains constant. Because internal energy depends upon temperature, so internal energy also constant in isothermal process. Clear? Now, according to first law of thermodynamics, see, let us take first law of thermodynamics. What is first law of thermodynamics? Says dQ is equal to dU plus dW. Clear? Because dU is equal to constant, internal energy is constant in isothermal process. dU value zero. Change in internal energy will be zero because internal energy is constant. That means whatever the heat energy that we are supplying to that gas in isothermal process, it will be utilized totally in performing work in expanding that gas or in compressing that gas. If you give heat energy to the gas will expand. Work is done by the system, by the gas. If you take heat energy from the gas will compress. Work will be done on the gas. Sign convention is important. Means, according to first law of thermodynamics, the heat energy which is given to the gas or system is totally utilized in performing work done. Clear?
Yes.
We know work done by the gas, like this indicator diagram, we have derived one equation. What is that formula, Anna? PdV. Work done by the gas formula, what, Anna? PdV. dW is equal to PdV. We have discussed. Clear? If you want total heat energy that we have to supply, then what we can do? We can do integration of PdV. This integration from where to where? From which volume to which volume we are taking? From initial volume V1 to final volume V2. So we have to take V1 to V2. Clear? Okay?
Yes.
So this heat energy I can write Q or W because in isothermal process dQ is nothing but dW. Clear? So I am writing W work done by the gas or heat energy supplied to the gas, both are same, will be equal to integration V1 to V2 PdV. Here what about P? P is what? P is not a constant. P is pressure. It is changing. As volume is changing, pressure also will change. Clear? That's why we can't take it out of the integration. Clear? So for that reason, we need to substitute in the place of P something else. That something else is nothing but according to ideal gas equation, PV equal to nRT. PV is equal to nRT. I am taking one mole of a gas, let us suppose. Then PV is equal to RT. Then what is P, Nana? P will be nothing but RT by V. Substitute this here. You will get work done by the gas is integration V1 to V2 RT by V into dV. Clear? Now, R is constant. Gas constant it is. Universal gravitational constant, R. It will come out of the integration. Whereas T, it is isothermal process. T is also constant. It will come out of the integration. Because T is constant, we have taken. Because we are discussing about isothermal process. Integration 1 by V dV. V1 to V2. Are you getting clear? Yes. Now, this value becomes, what Nana? RT into integration V1 to V2, 1 by V dV. Formula what Nana? Log to the base E. V. You will get. Log V. Integration of 1 by X dx. Formula what we got Nana? Integration of 1 by x dx, formula what we got? Log x. So in the place of 1 by v dv, I am writing log v. This log, natural logarithm, natural logarithm. Base e, we have to write. Okay? And it is having limit from where to where? V1 to V2. So that's why we have to write it as RT log to the base e V2 minus V1. Log V2 minus log V1. Minus log V1. We should write like this. This is the work done by the gas. And still it can be written as, we know log X minus log Y can be written as log of XYY. So it can be written as W is equal to RT log to the base V2 by V1 we can write. If you want to convert it into base 10, we should multiply with 2.303 with this. You will get log to the base 10 V2 by V1. Formula is important. 2.303 RT into log V2 minus log V1. Sorry, log V2 by log V1. This is a formula for work done by the gas in isothermal process. This work done will be nothing but heat energy supplied. Both are same. Okay? And sometimes they may give values in terms of pressure. They won't give volume. They won't give volume. They will give pressure. That time what we need to do? We know when temperature is constant, we can write PV is equal to constant according to ideal gas equation. Correct? Yes. Okay, temperature constant means we can write PV is equal to constant. That means P1 V1 should be equal to P2 V2. Then what is V2 by V1 Nana, from this? V2 by V1 is nothing but P1 by P2. Means this will become W is equal to 2.303 RT log to the base 10 P1 by P2. This also you may get. Clear? Okay, Nana? Yes. This is work done by the gas in isothermal process. Remember this, 2.303 RT log 10, log to the base 10, V2 by V1. Or 2.303 RT log to the base 10, P1 by P2. This for one mole of a gas, Nana. If you take n moles of a gas, then what will become? Here nRT, here n will add up. If you take n moles of a gas, here n will add up. That's it. N will be there everywhere. If you take n moles of a gas, simple. Are you understanding? Sometimes they will ask you questions for 1 gram of a gas. What is the formula? You know, N is nothing but mass upon molecular mass. You know this. Clear? Do you know? Yes. Number of moles is nothing but mass by molecular mass. So for 1 gram, W will become 2.303 RT by capital M. In the place of N, I am writing 1 by capital M. N is equal to 1 gram. Then N will become 1 by capital M. M is what? Molecular mass here. 2.303 RT by capital M into log to the base 10 V2 by V1. V2 indicates final volume, V1 indicates initial volume. It can be written as 2.303 RT by capital M log base 10 P1 by P2 also we can write. Okay, this is work done in isothermal process on a important. Okay, clear? And on this topic, we will take one or two examples, numerical examples in next session. Clear? Okay? Okay, bye.